Greetings, people. Paul Muckle here. Today is July 4th, 2013. People, have a very, very interesting thing to show you guys, right? Is this a UFO on the moon, people? Is this a UFO crossing the moon, people? Early this morning, right around 3:45 around there, right, I woke up, right, and look out my window. And as you guys know, those two trees in front of my house, right, right above them, right, I seen the moon, the new moon. And I said, wow. So people, I took out my camera, and I'm there filming the moon and talking, you know, y'all, I'm always talking. I speak to you guys, but I like I'm addressing the moon. So people, I'm talking to the moon, I'm talking to you guys about the bracelet, the electronic bracelet on my leg, the GPS, and people, this figure came across the moon, people. People, look at it. People, look at this arm, right? Look at this square, dark object that's sticking in front of the moon. This whole object, people, is covering the bottom of the moon right here. You could see it's covering it. That's an object. It's moving, people, okay? It's moving slowly across the moon. I'm going to show it to you guys, but people, it cannot be. Even though the moon is above some trees, right, it's too high above the trees. So the tree branches couldn't be doing that. And you will see the proof that it couldn't be the tree branches, because if it was the tree branches, right, you'll see it come back again. But it was not the tree branches, because like I said, the moon was too high. And also, people, it was not clouds, because people, look at how perfect. Look how perfect this object is. The part that's sticking in front of it. Look how perfect it is, people, and the top is like a triangle. You're about to see it. But I'm going to play it in slow motion for you guys first. Then I'll play it in regular speed. Okay, here you go in slow motion. Right? You're going to see the figure come, and it's going to cross the moon. It's moving. Then after this, I'm going to show you guys it in regular speed. I'm going to show you all the sun rising up. So it's very interesting, people. It's a UFO. Unless one of you could tell me definitely what it is, it's a UFO. It's not a man-made object. Look at it, people. Check out the front. Check out how square the front part is. Look at that. That cannot be a cloud. Now it has a square part like that in front, and it cannot be the tree because it's moving. Remember, the camera is just shaking, but I'm not moving. I'm just moving the moon a little bit with the camera, but the object, look at it, people, look. It can't be a cloud, not shaped like that. Okay, look at it, then I'm gonna show you all it in regular speed and what I was talking to it. And furthermore, people, if it was a tree, right? If it was a tree, it would have came back again, but it never came back. At least not there, so y'all gonna see for yourself. Look at the top of it, like, look at how it's shaped, people. Look at that. That cannot be a cloud. Not shaped like that. Very interesting. So, while you Americans out there celebrating y'all Independence Day, don't y'all know y'all don't have any independent Americans? You have no independence. Okay? Why y'all celebrating falsehood? You lost your independence in the 1814 war. Even though the tornado stopped the British from destroying Washington, D.C., it didn't make them lose their arms. It didn't help them win the war, because Quincy Adams Jr. and them others, or Quincy Adams, whichever it was, went to Belgium to sign their surrender to Nathan Rothschild. People see the top look like a triangle, like a needle, a triangle. Look at that. And it's moving, people. It's moving. Okay? It's not a plane, because it's moving too slow to be a plane. It's not a cloud because of the symmetry, the shape. So what is it? Anyway, like I was saying, Americans, you have no independence. So what are you celebrating? Okay? You're owned by the banksters. Okay? the British banks that y'all are owned by, Sir Evelyn Rothschild. Anyway, here you go, the rest of the video, people. Okay, here's the raw video.
Greetings, people, Paul Michael here. Today is July 4th, 2013, at 3:47 in the morning. I just woke up not too long ago, and I look out my window when it's about to do. I was about to do something. Look out my window and I seen the new moon, people, right between my gates. So the new moon rise. This is significant, people. This is very significant. This is very significant. Remember I told you that the quarter moon caused earthquakes? Remember I told you that the new moon, the quarter moon, it was the new moon I meant, the quarter new moon. This is what caused the Japanese earthquake. And March 11th, 2011. 3-11-11. This moon is what caused that earthquake. I really want an earthquake to smash that monument in Washington, D.C. That's their power structure. That's what protect them. Okay? That's where their power structure is at. In that monument. At least some of it. So I'm not trying to kill anybody, but that place needs to be destroyed. It's a place of evil and corruption. Is that a star next to the moon? Or is that something from the camera? Oh, yeah, that's the camera. Anyway, people, yesterday, July 3rd, was the 1 year anniversary when Babylon released me from prison. Remember they locked me up for 64 days? I got out on January 3rd. Then the bracelet came off my leg. I didn't even know the bracelet came off, people. But my feet got caught to something. And it yanked the bracelet off and I didn't know. It was only minutes after I looked at my leg and I realized the bracelet was missing. So they put me under house arrest. So July 4th, I was under house arrest from July 3rd to the 5th. The 5th, I went and they gave me a new strap and a bracelet. So, you know, I'm just celebrating my freedom. But I don't know what tomorrow holds. These people are really, really trying to put pressure on me to settle the case with them. Because the bankster, the weasel, know that they cannot convict me for the malicious prosecution and none of them charges. They cannot convict me on those. So they know it's gonna be hell to pay. And they're trying to pressure me into settling. And anyway, I wanna end this war, people. Honestly, I wanna end this war because I'd rather move on to better things, you know. I'd rather fight a spiritual warfare against the churches, you know. I know capitalism is what really, it changed the whole people, but religion is what really imprisoned the people's spirit. So you free them religiously, everything is gonna fall into place, but the devil is trapping me in this freaking war. In the courts, trapping me, you know, keeping my attention focused and fighting this silly war while religious iniquities are going on. So I just want to finish this financial war, you know, and my patience is waning. So yeah, come on, time to end this, okay? You're gonna hit Babylon one last severe blow to shut down Umi in business. Seriously. One last severe blow. A death blow. Let them know who the hell they're messing with. Okay? So I can move on to the next phase. time to knock down Babylon's throne. So my friends, be vigilant, send your spirit, okay people? We're not trying to destroy the world, we're not trying to kill people. We're trying to free ourselves, and it's going to take destruction to do it. It seems like total destruction is the only solution, because they ain't no use. Nobody can stop them now. Ain't no use. Nobody can stop them now. Give them an inch to take a yard. Give them a yard to take a mile. Once a man but twice a child. And everything is just for a while. It seems like total destruction is the only solution. And people, in a few hours, right, the sun is gonna rise right between these two trees though. Yeah, it's gonna fire. It smells like something is burning. Here it comes. The sun is coming up soon. The sun gonna be visible real soon. So we're gonna have the sun and the moon out together. Visible. July 4th, 2013. Morning people, July 4th, 2013, here comes the sun, here comes Rara, between the trees, just like the moon did last night, or earlier.